When I asked the folks over at Pyramid Air what would be their ideal air rifle for preppers and survivalists, they told me to go with this gun. Guys, this is Fernando doing another video for Modern Survivalists, and today we're taking a look at the Seneca Aspen by Air Venturi. As practical as 22 long rifle carbines are, in many ways air rifles have even more advantages. First of all is the matter of availability. These are not firearms, therefore the restrictions are much lower. You can get one of these shipped across the United States pretty much without any problem, checking your local laws of course, but even internationally, Pyramid Air, which is the largest air gun dealer in the planet, they shipped this to me to my door in Spain. I'll leave the link below for Pyramid Air and for you to check, depending on your country, there's a good chance that they deliver to your country as well without any restriction. Then of course there's a matter of price. An air rifle is also going to be cheaper than most firearms. And of course the ammunition as well. Often 22 long rifle is, you know, complimented and highly regarded for how cheap the ammunition is, and that goes as a good way to get new shooters practice and training without the high cost of ammunition. Now, pellets are even cheaper than that. These are 500 pellets, and this costs like $4 or $5. It's almost pretty much like 10 times cheaper than 22 long rifle. Then there's the matter of convenience as well. With an air rifle, you can shoot in your backyard, even in your basement. There's no trip to a range, there's no gun range fees or subscriptions or memberships. All that saves money. Then of course you have the matter of an air rifle like this being a gun that you can use for pest control, for small game hunting. In many ways, an air rifle is a gun that you can even use for these things within suburban areas where firearms are restricted from being used. For planking, for training, for learning those basic marksmanship skills that you need, there's really no contender to what you can do with a good air rifle. The Seneca Aspen is not your childhood break-action air gun. It's a serious rifle. One of the unique characteristics is it's a PCP air rifle with a built-in pump. PCP air rifles have the advantage of having a little bit more power. They're usually more accurate because you don't have a spring moving inside when you shoot, and it allows for follow-up shots. Now, the disadvantage is that with a PCP air gun, you'll also need a larger air tank so as to fill it up, or a compressor. So in this case, that's not needed because you have the built-in pump. This also works like a handle once it's locked. Once you unlock it, you move it so as to fill up the reservoir of air. And it's of course much easier done without the camera between your hands. About 50, 60 pumps are gonna be filling it up. And you have the gauge there telling you how much pressure you have. Of course, don't go past red. That's basically it. You have the lever action and you use it the following way. You open it, you put a pellet there in the tray, you close it, you move the safety forward, that is it, ready to shoot. You can also remove the little tray, look how easy that is, and you put the magazine in there. This is 10 shots, you put it in there and you use it like a bolt action gun, going back and forth, working the lever, and you use your 10 shots. One of the nice things that you have in the Seneca Aspen is also that you can adjust the setting of how much power you have to either low or high. The Seneca Aspen comes in three calibers. This is the 177, it also comes in 22 and 25. 177, you have on a high setting, it's gonna be going at 1,000 feet per second on high, 800 on low. For 22, it's gonna be 900 feet per second on high, 700 feet per second on low. And for 25, the largest caliber is gonna be 800 feet per second on high, 550 on low. My advice would be to go for like a general purpose do everything air gun, which probably is what you want. Go with a 22. That's a good caliber, and it's gonna be that middle ground between, it's not the largest caliber, the more powerful one, but it's a good in-between point, especially if you're gonna be using it for plinking, pest control, a little bit of small game hunting. The 4.5 millimeter is very popular here in Europe. It's maybe the more accurate one, but that would be my suggestion. Of course, you also get the scope, which is a 4x32 scope. which allows for a nice level of accuracy at middle ranges. Now, I've been using this air gun for several weeks now, so as to be confident for this review. I didn't just jump into this. But let's go one more time to the range, see the type of groups we get, and get back to it. So once I figured out what pellets the gun likes best, I started shooting some groups. In my case, the ones that seemed to work best would be these H&N Sport, your typical air gun pellet used for target shooting, but for small birds, critters, and some pest control too, it's gonna be good enough as well. And some of the nicer groups I got, I was thinking about covering these with a quarter, really no point, a dime will do. 10 yards, this is a three-shot group at 10 yards, and those two are just one on top of the other. Then you have another shot, another group with those pellets at 20 yards, again, 20 yards covering those with a dime. And of course, once you adjust the scope, you are getting still dime-size groups at 20 yards. Here as well, this is a very nice group, maybe the nicer group I got. And at 25 yards, still 25 yards, that sort of group, covering it still with a dime. Guys, it's a very accurate gun. It's a very powerful gun. If you do your part, the gun will do its as well. If you're interested in this sort of thing, check the link below from Pyramid Air. Great people. That's going to be all for now, folks. Subscribe to the channel. See you on our next video.